This is Frida. Welcome to my channel. For today's tutorial, I am going to be showing you how to crochet this lovely piece. It's a rainbow colored and it looks fantastic. So what I did is I gathered the yarn that I have in my stash. The reason I wanted to share this tutorial, first, it looks fantastic. I just love the rainbow colors, and I thought it's when you look at it, it just brings you back to life, and it means it will be all right. Well, this will all pass, so there would be nothing to worry about. It makes a relief when you look at it. So I wanted to share it with you. And then these are mercerized thread, the yarn or thread, whichever you would like to call this. I bought these from Dollarama, and there were a package for four. I did do a yarn haul about this. You're welcome to go and check my yarn haul. It's 100% cotton, and it has that mercerized feeling to it. And I picked up the color that are in my stash, so I'm going to start it and hang it on my window so other people, when they're walking by, because I'm at a lot here and I have lots of people walking by, and they can see, and then they would, you know, smile. Just gives you a spirit, nothing to it. And it's like a half mandala. You can make a mandala if you want, just make it in a round, and then you can go from there. Okay, so I'm just gonna grab my crochet hook and let's get started. So I started with a red, and I'm gonna last with the red. I didn't have another ball of the same color, so I'm just kind of thinking, should I grab another red, because I'm going to be doing the fringes as well. Let's see, we're not going to be using that much, so I'm sure it's going to be enough. So let's get started. Grab the yarn that you have that is closest to the rainbow color. It can be pastel rainbow. It can be, I don't know, dark colors. It can be different colors. It doesn't have to be rainbow. Just the colors that you like, and then we'll go from there. For this being thin, I believe it's a 1 weight. I'm just going to use my 2.5. It doesn't say here what crochet hook to use. Just give me the gram and the meter and the yard. So I'm just going to use my judgment, and I'm just going to pull it. And I'm going to chain total of 4. Usually when we do a round, or you can make a magic loop either way, or you can chain 4. Just like this, and then secure it. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to chain 2 to go up, and then I'm going to make a total of 7 double crochets. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. I'm going to pull it like this. So this is how it will look like. Okay, I just wanted to show you, as you can see, it's done in 2 rows. So we did the 7 double crochet, and then when I go to the next row, we're going to double. It's like doing a round, but this is semi-round, so we're just going to do what we do in a round, because the more we crochet, so we want it to become bigger, right? So we're just going to, on the second row, we're going to do 2 double crochets on each double crochet that we crocheted. So you should have 14 double crochets on your next row. Please don't ask me a pattern. I'm just looking at the picture, and I am crocheting while I see the picture. I still get lots of comments. Even I get emails for a pattern. Even I say several times I don't have a pattern. If I do have a pattern, I will put it on the below, which I do not want to do patterns, because then I get into trouble. So I'm just doing my way, and I'm sharing my my experience with you guys, so you can, it would be easier for you to make it, or otherwise it's really hard sometimes, and I'm trying to be as helpful as I can because I love helping people. So what I did is I finished the seventh and I chained three, and then I am going to do two double crochets on each double crochet, just like this. If you want it tinier, you can make half double crochet. If you want it smaller, you can make single crochet. It's your preference, but I prefer double crochet because I want it big on my window, so everyone when they're walking by, they can see it. Thought it's would be nice. Okay. Just like this, two double crochets on each double crochet. Let me know if you don't like the black background. I can flip it back to the gray. I thought it would be easier for you guys to see it. Let me know. Okay, so I did my last one, and I'm going to go back and count. So we should have a total of 14. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. Okay, now I'm going to change my color to purple. Okay, so I'm going to change the color, and I'm just going to grab the purple, just like this. Can leave it long if you want. 1, 2, 3. And on this row, what we're going to do is we're going to crochet 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1 on each single crochets. So I'm going to start with two double crochet, and on the next I'm going to do one double crochet all the way. 2, 1, 2, 1. So I will meet you at the end, because the more we're crocheting, the more we're going to get more double crochets on each. Yeah, I'm just gonna leave these because we're gonna make fringes, right? So it won't be that of a big deal, and I can cut this later on. This red that I changed the color, because the last row is going to be red. So I will continue crocheting. I'll meet you at the end. 2, 1, 2, 1. And I believe this is 1, 2, 3 row. Okay, so I finished this row. Doesn't this look nice? The last one ends with a one double crochet, so nothing to worry about. So I'm going to chain three, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to do two double crochet here, and then we're going to go to 2, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1. If I have the time, I will write what I'm doing. Like, it's not going to be a pattern, it's just going to be simple what I've been doing. And I am repeating what I'm doing, so I don't know why you guys are asking me a pattern. Okay, so yeah, maybe it's easier for you to look at it while you're crocheting. I get it, because I take notes too, but you can take notes while you're watching me. And yeah, so 2, 1, 1. So I did 2, 1, 1, and then I'm doing 2. And I'm going to repeat this, and then it's going to get wider, just like this. 2, 1, 1. And I will meet you at the end, and we'll start our blue color. Okay, so I finished row 4, and this is how it looks like. And what I did is I did 2, 1, 1. I finished with a 1. So I'm just going to join my yarn just like this, and then I will tie these just to secure it, just to show you, because one, two, three, chain, and then I'm going to do, so on the fifth row, we're going to do 2, 1, 1, 1. So there's going to be 3 ones between. So 2 double crochets in one chain, and then we do 1 double crochet on one chain, and 1 double crochet, and then we do another one on the next one, and then we do another one. So it's 2, 1, 1, and then we repeat that all the way to the end. Okay, and I will meet you at the end. Okay, so I just finished row 5, and this is how it looks like. So I'm going to, again, this I did 2, and then I did 1, 1, 1. So at the last one, ended with a 1, and I'm going to chain 3, go up, and do my second row. I noticed that it is pretty soft. Maybe I should have used a smaller hook, but let's see, because I'm already half there. So I'll just finish this, and I'll see how it would work. Maybe my yarn is thin. So, yeah, if you have other yarns, you are welcome to use it. It doesn't have to be what I'm using. It's just that what I have in my stash that meets the color that I saw and fell in love in the picture. Okay, so I'm on row 6, and what I'm going to do is I did 2, and then I'm going to do 2, 1, 1, 1, 1. So there's 4 1 repeats. So 1, 2, 3, and then fourth one, and then I start back with a 2. So I repeat this all the way to the end. So the reason we're doing the 2 in 1 double crochet, so it would not stretch, like it won't, so it would go nice and smooth around, and it gives you that nice look. And we use these techniques in anything that we crochet around. So I did my 2, and I'm going to do 4 ones on each double crochet. Okay, it's very easy and simple, and it looks elegant. The color just gives you that, oh my goodness, gives you that nice relief. The colors that, you know, play around with us. So I did 1, 2, 3, 4, and I'm going to do my 2. Okay, and I'll meet you at the end to change our color. Okay, so I just finished my row 6, and I'm going to start row 7. And this is how it looks like. I did 2, 1, 1, 1, 1, and I finished with a 1. Okay, so I'm just going to join 1, 2, 3, and try to pull this. Again, I will tie these ends. Turn my work, and I'm going to do 2, and then I'm going to do 5 times 1, 1, 1, 1. So every row we're increasing 1, and then this is all to it. So what I'll do is I will let you crochet, because this is what I'm doing. I'm not doing anything different, and I just wanted to share how I do it, how I would do it, and I will try to write down what I'm doing if I have the time again. Everyone's home though. It's and I'm trying to post, if you notice lately, I'm trying to post every day a video, so no one would get bored at home, right? And then they would see new new stitches, new patterns, new looks. So I did 2, 1, 1, 1, 1, and I'll do my 5th. So we're doing 1, we did 2, 4, 6, 7, 7th row. And I'll meet you at the end. Okay, so I just finished this row. As you can see, it's getting bigger, and it's not fitting my hand right now. So just want to show you. So I did 2, and then 1, 1, 1, 1. So it's always ending. Let's say you forgot counting, and you had to go back. Just count what you did, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. On the next row, we're going to do 6. And then on the next row would be 7 until we finish. And this is all to it. 1, 2, 3, we chain up. And then we start with a 2. This is how I figured out with looking at the picture with my experience. So if you know how to do it, you can, you know, crochet the way that you know. But this is how I figured it out. Okay, so I'm going to let you crochet and I will finish all these colors, because this is all we're doing. And this is pretty soft, so I don't know, maybe I'll maybe you can put a wire between, or maybe you can put it in a I did a tutorial on how to do my doilies I forgot the name. I think I put but did I have to go back and watch that video? Because I like doing my videos. I can always go back and watch them. Because, you know, I write it down and I can't find it. And this is a good, great way for me to go back and what I did. So I can maybe, that's what I'll do. I'll have this put into that liquid. I think it was flour. Was it corn scrub? I can't remember what I the ingredients at the moment. But it will make it thicker. And then I can hang it on the window, so I don't even have to put a wire. But you are welcome to. But and then or you can do, you know, those mandanas that you do in a round. You can even put that around, half round, and hang it on your window. There's endless ways to do it. So I will continue crocheting just the way we're doing, and then we'll go from there. And I will show you how to put the fringes and how it will look like. Ta-da! I'm almost finished! Yeah, I just want to show you how to make the handle to, you know, put it on something on a wall or whichever you were going to put it on. But it's turning perfect! I love the colors! Oh my goodness! Okay, so I'm in the middle. I just measured it, you know, with my eye, and I'm in the middle. So I'm just going to chain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. When you go like this, it's too small. 9, 10, 11, 12. Let's go 6, 6. I think this is small too. I don't know. 12, 13, 14, 15. Just use your judgment and how you want it. 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. I think 20 is better. And then measure it, and what I'm going to do is it's like a picot that you make. You just go between and secure it here with the single, and you make your handle. So I'm going to continue. So I'm on the last row, and I did my 2, and I'm doing total of 12 double crochets. So 12 and then 2. And then you do 12 double crochets, and then you do 2 double crochets on the same. So I'm going to continue crocheting, and I will meet you at the end, and we will do the fringes. Yeah, and then, yeah, I noticed this is pretty soft, so I will put the link below on how I did my doilies that had holes with a scratch, and I will use the second recipe. I have 2 recipes in that video. I shared my... what I did with my doilies that holes on it. I made baskets out of them, and then they turn. I still use them. I made that video August 9, 2018, and today is 2020, March 26, and I still use those baskets. I haven't even washed them because they're not dirty. But yeah, hopefully in the summer I will wash them, and then I will redo them again. Okay, so I will finish this. Yeah, you need to, like, this is pretty soft. When you hang it, it has to be thick. You know, it needs to have it scratch. I'll be right back. Ta-da! Doesn't this look lovely? Okay, so I'm going to do the fringes. And I'm just going to grab a cardboard that I have. It's just a cardboard, or you can use anything to make your fringes. And I am going to attach to them. Let me see. So I'm just going to grab it. Oh, the screen went dark. It's odd. Okay, so I'm just going to grab it and I'm going to go over like this. I don't know. several times. And I have to be cautious because I only have one red ball. And I have to do two on each. So two here, four. Yeah, and then two here. So I need to be cautious while I'm doing this. And I'll be right back to show you how to go with that. Okay, so I did about 10. I think 10 is enough. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to cut it and cut this from here. Oops. Lost it. So I'm going to cut this here. And then I'm going to cut this just like that. Don't leave it, because then you will just grab a big crochet hook that you have, or I don't know, I think you need a smaller one. And then what we're going to do is I'm just going to grab this. So this is the middle. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to attach this from here. And then, oh boy, did it go through? Yeah, all of them went through. Yeah, okay. So, just gonna go like, oh, see, the half is, it has to be equal on both sides. Then try to work on this. Okay, try to have it like this, nice and tight, and then make a flip knot like this, and then pull everything nicely, just like this. It has to be nice and tight. Ta-da! And we made our first French. So I'm going to continue making this. It's going to take time, and I will come back to show you the end result. And then we'll go from there. Oh my goodness, this is turning out pretty good. I'm so excited about it. I'll be right back to show you the end result. It's going to take me a while. Ta-da! I finished it. Oh my goodness, the fringes took me forever. Okay, so this is how it looks like. And I brushed it with the comb that I have here. I used a comb to brush it, and I'm just going to trim it. And what I'm going to do is I will put the link below. You need to use starch, and I have two recipes that you can use it. And it won't stay on the window because this part is pretty thin, like it's very light, and then this is heavy. This is going to be heavy, so when you starch it, I'm sure it's going to be thick, and it will look nice on your window. So I hope you liked this tutorial. I just had to share what I was going through to create this lovely rainbow. And I hope whoever sees it passing by from your house will through this terrible lockdown that we're going through. And it will put a smile to everyone. Thank you very much for watching my tutorials. And have a great day.